Now, you went to New York, it was, what was the year, 1967?
Yeah, 66, 67, yeah.
Okay, which also, I mean, that was a pretty revolutionary time in American history.
Oh, it was. I woke up practically the first day I was there and turned on the radio, and they were talking about the strange thing that had happened. There were some soldiers going off to Vietnam in the Grand Central Station, and a whole group of young people had descended upon them and stuck flowers in the barrels of their guns.
Right.
It was the onset of the protest and the hippie movement and all of that stuff. And and one of the centers of that was a church, a Baptist church, actually, Judson Memorial in Greenwich Village, that was a totally radical church and hosted a theater. They had actually turned the balcony of their church into a theater. And they did these radical off Broadway plays, and they also had a dance theater in that church, and they were a center to organize protests and all kinds of things like that.
Did you ever take part in any of that, or were you just sitting on the outside just watching?
Yeah, I guess I felt like I was this Canadian, you know, that it was not my battle, but I was watching it and admiring it, but feeling somewhat distant from it.
Right. Now, did you meet anybody special?
Of course. The first day I was there, I noticed this wonderful young woman who had grown up in segregated South in Houston, and she was asking all the interesting questions I noticed that she was in one of the classes that I took. Mm-hmm. But this was Rita Shelton, who became Rita Shelton Devereaux later. Rita had worked for the Alley in Houston as an apprentice because they wouldn't let her into the theater school of the theater.
Really?
Because it was whites only.
Wow.
She was studying. She had gone to a university on Long Island, and studied drama, and then decided she had a drama scholarship, but decided universities were good for something else other than teaching theater, so she switched to philosophy. And then she always intended to be an actor, but then she decided there was something religious behind theater, so she went to Columbia to do a master's to study history of religions.
Right.
And so she was taking a course with Tom Driver about imagination and revelation at Union, because they had a cooperative with Columbia, courses, so it would count towards her MA.
Right.
And that's where I met her. And I fell madly in love. My head was spinning. I manipulated things so that I spent the afternoon that I met her at her apartment reading one of the textbooks. And she invited me for dinner. And she still had a bit of a Texas accent at the time. And when she was standing over the two-burner grill that she had in her apartment, she asked me what I thought of garlic. And I misunderstood, and I thought she asked me what I thought of God. And so I went into a long discourse about my theology. And she said that, she was gracious enough to say that was very interesting, but what did I think of garlic?
And was your explanation?
My explanation, well, I don't know which had the most influence, my appreciation of garlic or my theology.
At any rate, we
went home to Aurelia for Christmas to announce our engagement. And
which is pretty fast.
I think it was about a couple of weeks after I met her. I wanted to leave and just figure out what was happening to me, and she got worried that I was leaving, and I said, no, let's come for a walk. And we walked down by the Hudson River, and we stood in the shelter of one of the public washrooms, because there was a very bitter wind blowing off the river, and I said, you see how cold this is? It's colder in Canada.
And she said.
She said, yes. She's recounted this story and said she didn't know that we'd end up living in Regina.
Of all the places in Canada to go, that would be a cold awakening.
Yeah, so that you asked me if I had met anybody special. Yeah. Yes.
So you did.
Yes.
And you both moved to Canada.
We both came to St. Thomas, where I was, that's down near London, Ontario, where I was a pastor in a small home mission church for 3 years. And then I took a year off to write plays and never actually got back to being, never got back to the pastoring.
Right.
Yeah.
Because you became.